Hey there, this is René for networklessons.com and in this video you will learn about Network Address Translation, or NAT. Yeah. So before we can look at NAT, let me first explain a scenario where we do not do any translation. Yeah? So for example, I got a host over here, which is on my own network, yeah? So it has a private IP address. We have a router at home. And this is the IP address that I got from my ISP. It's a public IP address. We are connected to the internet somehow, and then on the other side somewhere there is a DNS server or any other server which has IP address 8888, which happens to be Google DNS, and also it's connected to a router somewhere. Yeah? So when this host wants to send something to the DNS server, it will create an IP packet and it will look like this. So it has a source, IP, which is this address over here, and the destination will be 8888. Yeah? Like this. This will be the IP packet. Now, the host will forward this packet to our router. A router will send it to its ISP. And then the ISP router will route it somehow, and it will end up at the other side, at this router, which will forward it to the server over here. Yeah? And the server will do something with it, and probably wants to send an IP packet of its own to the host. Yeah? So this IP packet, what will it look like? Well, it will look like this. The source, which is 8888. And the destination, which will be 192.168.1.1. Yeah. The server will forward this IP packet to the router, and the router that is connected to the internet might even forward it to its ISP. And then the ISP will say, okay, that's all very nice and all that, but this address over it, this destination, is a private IP, and we do not route any private IP addresses. Yeah? So this packet, it will be dropped. Yeah? It will never make it onto the internet. Okay, so what we have to do is we need to use network address translation. Now, how does it work? We'll enable it on this router. So on our router at home. Network address translation. Once we enable network address translation, our host will still create this same IP packet. It will be forwarded to the router over here. And what this router will do, it will say, okay, what I'm going to do is translate the source IP address to the public IP address that I received from my ISP. Yeah? So what it will do is this. It will translate it to this IP address. So that means that the IP packet will look like this now. Yeah? 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. Now this IP packet with the changed source IP address, it will be forwarded to the ISP on the internet. It makes it to this router, and then it makes it to this DNS server. Yeah? And then the same thing, this DNS server will want to respond to this IP packet. But now it thinks that it's talking to not this private address, but it thinks that it's talking to this address, since that was the source. Yeah? There we go. The DNS server will send this packet to the router, to the ISP. Then it will be routed, and it will end up over here at our home router. Now, and what will this router do then? It will translate the public IP back to the private IP address that we have. Yeah? So the packet that it receives, so this packet over here, it will be received by this router. And then what it will do is it will change the IP address again. Yeah? So it will look like this. So it will receive the packet and then it will change packet. It will change the IP address, and then it will be forwarded to the host. Okay? And then everything is working fine. Yeah. So the host has no clue that its IP address is being changed. Only this router does. And the DNS server over here, it thinks that it is talking with this IP address. Yeah? So that's the how network address translation works. And in some other videos, I will be talking about some different methods. So we got static net, there is dynamic net, we got PAT, port address translation, and some other stuff. But I'll keep that for some other videos. So for now, I hope this has been useful. Thanks for watching, and till next time.